get ready to match the stars. Richard Paul, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Joanne Flug, Bill Daly, and from Flo, Joyce Guillemot, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now, here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rivers!
Thank you, John. You really got them riled up, John. Well, don't do that. You're going to spoil us, and we'll never let you go if you keep on doing that. Are you ready, gang?
Yes, we're ready.
Yes. Let's say hello to Mary Graham and Chuck Worthy. Applause. I want to find out who you are and where you're from. Chuck, we'll begin with you, sir.
All right. My name is Chuck Worthy. I'm from Memphis, Tennessee. And a year ago, I retired. And we've traveled this grand country for the last year, seeing a good part of it, and would like to continue.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
Gorgeous.
Is America the greatest
state.
Place in the world?
You got that right.
Right. Here, here. All right. Mary.
Hi, I'm Mary Graham. I'm originally from Ann Arbor, Michigan, and I moved out here a year and a half ago to pursue an acting career, and I'm also a very happy newlywed.
Well, you're a very beautiful young lady. You should be successful.
Well, thank you.
Isn't she pretty?
Oh, beautiful.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'll take one of those.
Yeah. You take one of those?
Yeah.
All right.
Chuck's cute. Chuck is cute.
I'll take one of those.
I like
take
girls.
One of each of those.
I got to point out to both of you that here on Match Game PM, you'll each have three opportunities to match as many of those creatures as you can. The one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner, and that person will go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $20,000.
All right.
How about that? Here we go. Chuck, A or B?
Let's try B.
Chuck says he wants B. Here's what B says. Tim said,
yes.
I got bad news and worse news.
Oh,
bad news is my wife ran through a red light. The worst news is the light was on a blank. The light was on a blank. Here we go. Tim said, I got bad news and worse news. The bad news is my wife ran through a red light. The worst news is the light was on a blank.
A police car.
A police car, excellent. Want to feel goofy now?
Yeah.
All right.
Well, he's a partner, right? But in my neck of the woods, we pronounce it a police car.
A police
yeah,
car.
That's right, Chuck.
I'm going to help you, buddy.
Yep.
I'm going to help you.
I'm going to help you. Walk the line. Walk the line.
Right.
In my part of the country, we pronounce it house of ill repute.
Yeah! Aha!
Isn't that the red light?
Yeah.
Well, it's house of ill repute.
Repute.
Oh, pardon me. Yeah. House of ill repute.
Repute. Yeah.
All right.
House of ill fame.
They're both referring to the chicken farm, as it's called, in outside of Houston, Texas.
Yeah, I hope smile.
Hello, honey, Joanne.
Hi, Montague. How are you?
Well, bad news, wife ran through a red light. Worst news, light was on a...
Policeman.
That's really bad.
Yeah. He said police
Thank
car.
Thank you, one person who applied.
Thank you, one person. What do you got there?
In my part of the country, they just say police car, which is
they
the right
that.
Answer.
My daughter will be upset. You're going again.
Okay.
I said she ran through a coal miner's light.
A coal miner's light.
Strange, Joy.
Hit him
strange.
Right in the uppers. So Chuck picks up two in his first round question, which is pretty good for a first rounder. George Jessel said.
No.
Well, listen, resident mimic. I'll just say George Jessel said, and you do the rest, all right?
This is not the best, folks, so bear with
me. No, it's all right. George Jessel said.
I presided over a funeral. And it was terrible. In the middle of my eulogy, the guy in the coffin blanked.
Now, is that George Jessel? Now, wait a minute. Now, I want to know. That is not George Jessel.
That's George Jessel.
Come on.
Yesterday, I was dying over
this is George Jessel with a hair lip.
Yesterday I presided over a funeral and it was terrible. In the middle of my eulogy, the guy in the coffin blanked.
Good.
Okay, Steve, start without me. Let's go back and say, I'm not there. Start without me.
And then today, yesterday I presided over a funeral and it was terrible. In the middle of my eulogy, the guy in the coffin blanked.
Laughed.
Laughed? All right. She said laughed.
How quickly they turn.
Right.
Actually, he was allergic to long speaking, so he sneezed.
He sneezed.
No.
Did she say the corpse laughed?
Laughed.
Laughed.
Georgie
laughed.
Jessel hasn't gotten a laugh since 1948.
Belched. He belched.
Right. He snores.
Snores!
Now you're getting to it. The guy in the
After Richard and after me now with Charles.
No, Brett snored is better because the guy in the coffin was getting bored with George Jessel.
Oh.
That's the point.
Yeah. No, Dick Tracy.
Oh, boy. All right, go.
Go.
In the middle of my eulogy, the guy in the coffin, what?
Burped.
He burped. Any laughter for Mary Graham?
I happen to be wearing that guy in the coffin suit, by the way. I just...
They changed heads.
Yes, it changed heads, right.
I thought you were bomb, not in-bomb.
Oh, in-bomb. Well, I am half-bomb.
Oh. Such a spoil sport.
Comment to that bad joke, he yawned.
Yawned! A wonderful answer. Oh, snored and yawned so far have my vote as the yes.
I like burps.
I said he sang, mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord.
He has loosed the grave, the
nation of mine, and fries his heart.
All right, so it's 2-0 in the end of round one in Chuck's favor. Round two coming up in a moment. First this for you. Hello. Round two coming up. Now, let's see. Chuck, your head. You have to go first.
Let's go with B.
B. All right. Jim said, my wife is not too handy. Today, she tried to dry my shorts in the blank. You don't play.
I know.
All right. Jim said, my wife is not too handy. Today, she tried to dry my shorts in the blank.
In the toaster.
In the toaster. Cute answer, right?
It is. It's an adorable answer, and I wish I thought of it, but he rushed me. Or I probably would have thought
you weren't concentrating.
I was. I was getting help from Richard Paul. Oven.
All right. Oven is good.
Actually, Jeannie, you could dry a bra in a toaster, but it would be hard to dry shorts in them.
How do you spell it?
You could stuff them in there.
You have those two compartments, you know. It's kind of hard.
All right, what do you got?
Stove. S-T-O-V-E. Stove.
You'll be all right. Take two aspirin and call me in the morning. All right. My wife is not too handy. She tried to dry my shorts in the...
Well, she's very quick, and she wanted them done very rapidly, so she used the radar range.
Radar range. Right. All right, Joyce.
He's not going to do anything.
Well, what would you like me to do? What do you have to do?
I could tell you.
Oh. Oh. I'm sorry, I didn't know that you didn't have...
No, I got it. She tried to dry them in the hot tub.
Hot tub. That's dumb because it's full of water, so I think that's a pretty good answer.
That's very dumb.
All right, Mary, let's see what we have for you here. Hey, did you hear about the world's dumbest Eskimo?
No!
How dumb was that Eskimo?
I'll tell you about him. He went all the way to the White House because he wanted to blank the presidential seal. Johnny.
Come on, Chuck, baby.
The world's dumbest Eskimo, Mary. He went all the way to the White House because he wanted to blank the presidential seal.
Hunt.
Hunt. Good. I'd say Hunt. A good response. Isn't that a good answer?
Yes. It's a very good answer. And what does an Eskimo do when he hunts a seal?
Spears him.
He
right?
Harpoons it.
Harpoons.
That's part of the hunt.
Yeah.
Part of the hunt.
show them your spear. Show them. You're going to throw a javelin right at you there.
I've got it in the car. I'll bring it in.
He wanted to recapture and take back to Alaska the presidential seal.
Yeah, what does that have?
Have anything to do with hunting?
Recapture, take back to Alaska? No. All right.
Why are you booing? Now, wait a minute. We'll do this again.
No, once was more than enough.
Oh, I love you when you get racy like that.
You're so cute. You're in my will. You're all right. Yeah.
I'm going to show you my shoulders.
Doesn't Brett look like a can-can dancer?
She does look like a can-can dancer.
Yeah. She can, all right.
But she can't. Now, what? Charles is going to throw another one of his catatonic fits if we don't get to him soon.
Skin
the presidential seal.
That's ugly, Charles. That was ugly.
He went all the way to the White House because he wanted to hunt the presidential seal.
I've got something very close.
What?
Catch. So you catch fish. That's very good. No. You catch fish, which is like hunting animals. It's very close, Ira. Wrong.
Nice try.
I tried, Mary.
Okay, Bill.
Hang on to your booze.
Oh, no. Here he goes.
Have it fitted into a winter coat. The boos were not on. That was a very weak boo. You weren't sure.
It's a save the seal.
I said he wanted to eat the presidential seal. Oh.
Now we go to round three. Chuck, you're still ahead. You go first.
Let's go with B again.
It is. Here it is.
All right. I'm
going to
play this.
Gloria sued her husband, her ex-husband, for non-support because when he left her, he took her blank.
Oh, I love it. It's cute. It's a cute question.
I want to answer this one, Gene.
You don't play?
I know.
All right. Here we go, Chuck. Gloria sued her ex-husband for non-support because when he left her, he took her blank.
Credit cards.
Credit cards. Chuck.
Sorry about that.
The score is 2-0 in your favor. And unless she blows it completely, you just blew it now.
All right.
We'll hear in a moment or so. Go, Brett.
Well, I started to say jockstrap, and then I suddenly realized I had the sections confused.
Right.
So I said bra.
Right.
You're my people.
Explain it to him, Mary. All right, Charles.
Bra.
All right, let's do it. Suit of her non-support. We left her. He took her what, Joanne?
Well, I found their answers very tacky and rude. I said girdle.
Girdle. All right, Joyce.
I'm old-fashioned. I said her merry widow.
Merry widow.
No, just old.
So, you need 2 to tie and 3 to win.
You'll get yours.
Here's the way it goes, folks. So. The mad scientist crossed a mouse with a dog. Now he has a mouse that chases blanks. The mad scientist crossed a mouse with a dog. Now he has a mouse that chases blanks.
Cats.
Their answer is cats. Her answer is cats. What's yours?
Very clever.
Cats. Now that's a clever idea. Why didn't I think of that? Cats.
You did. You did. All right.
You chase it. And you chase it. You cat. What'd she say?
Cats.
Don't shout. You know that turns me on when you shout.
When I call on you, I want you to show your answer. All right, fourth time. 2-2. One more wins the game.
Cats.
Cats wins the game. What the rest of you have down here?
Cats.
Cars. Newspaper boy. Come on down, boys. Now, you take your place on this little blue jacket. I'll get rid of all the cables so you don't trip on that. And we'll say goodbye to Chuck Worthy. We have some wonderful prizes for you, Chuck. A can of mildew and a mosquito bite.
It's a lot of fun.
All right. Now a little message for you. Hurry back. See if she wins. She said, I didn't think I was going to make it there for a while. Well, you came through in the end, and you did very well with that third question. So here you are, Mary. You got a chance at the big money. Two audience matches for you here. You could really win a bundle. Let's see what happens. We polled the studio audience, said, write down your best answer to this. Sweet and sour. If you name the answer they gave us most often, we'll give you the $500. For naming the second most popular answer, $250. And then for the third, $100. Whom do you want?
I will take Richard.
Oh, I can't. Wonderful.
Sweet and sour
pork.
Sweet and sour.
Okay. And Brett?
Sweet and sour spare ribs.
Sweet and sour spare ribs.
That's wonderful, isn't that wonderful?
Joyce?
Sweet and sour shrimp.
Now, you think about this carefully now. You got sweet and sour pork, sweet and sour spare ribs, sweet and sour shrimp. Now you have the option. Choose one of those or think up one of your own.
I'll go with sweet and sour pork.
All right. Sweet and sour jello. What about sweet and sour pickles?
Oh,
yeah. That up there? Sweet and sour what?
Sweet and sour ice cream.
Sauce. Well, we'll see if the audience's answer is up there.
That's good.
Let's see if you got sauce up there. Go. Pickles. There's mine. All right, we want pork for this lady. Let's see if we got it under the next one, please. Sauce. There's the audience's answer. Well, we've had my answer, the audience answer, and now I hope it's your answer. Here it is. You got it. So now you've got $500, means at least you'll play is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. But you could do just as well with your next one. Here we go. I've got your blank. Who do you want over here?
Richard, the best gyrations.
I've got your number, buddy. Charles?
I've got your wife.
Who else? They're all averting
Everybody's
their gaze.
Down.
They're averting their...
We all had numbers.
Yes. Well, somebody's got to be called on.
Bill.
Bill.
Okay, name. I've got your
Get
name.
Get up here.
What? She didn't call
called
me.
On you.
You couldn't call on me.
Listen,
I've got your doorknob. No, that doesn't make any sense at all.
Say number, and then if it's number over there, she'll come over and give you a kiss.
She'll give me a kiss if I got... Well, I could win something, right? Yes. Why don't you kiss me now in case I have a bad number? How about I get your wallet? I do happen to have your wallet.
Is that it?
I don't have anything else, sorry.
I got your wallet, wife, or number?
I'll have to go with number.
Yeah. All right. Let's see if number is up there under the $100 response. Handle. All right. Let me just do a little police action here.
That's
a little
got your
handle.
What?
I don't know.
I got your handle.
At CB Talk, Brett. Let's take a look at the next one. I've got your goat.
No, you get my goat.
All right. Last chance. Here we go. Number it is.
Very good.
Another 500, another 5,000 added to the previous amount gives you a pot of $10,000 to shoot for. However, Mary, we want you to spin the wheel and see if you can double it up and play for $20,000. Good luck. We'll all root for a double. All right, it makes one revolution. Right. Yep. Gotta land right on a star. Close. All right.
Good luck, sweetheart.
Here we go. Good luck to you, my dear. It's worth $10,000. Blank, your wagon. Want to read it? All right. No help from the audience because it may be a rotten answer you're giving her. Charles, you want to read it?
He already has it written down for
Jay. Oh, good. All right.
He's a pro.
Splendid.
Well, I wouldn't say that.
Director of theater.
Now, your job, Mary, is to match Charles. If you do that, you get $10,000. What do you say?
I say paint your wagon.
Paint your wagon. Why did you say that?
Well, because I know Charles is in the theater, and that's a place. So
yes, it was a wonderful show.
Did you ever hear of Olga San Juan and Tony Bavar?
Olga San Juan, yes.
Well, you should have, because they were the stars of Paint Your Way.
Mary's husband, Gilbert. He's just as happy as she is. She has the $11,000. Join us next week for Match Game PM. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive the amount of touch latitude radar range microphone. Converted brand rice with evergreen scheme to remove stickiness and seal in more of the natural brand nutrients. And a baby bath and changing pad and Zyperine baby powder made with naturally absorbent cornstarch to keep babies dry and comfortable. 100% talc-free Zyperine baby powder. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production.